We're going to look at the effect of adding an inert on chemical equilibrium. So the idea is we have a system at constant temperature, gas phase reaction, a 1 mole reacting to 2 moles, and then we add an inert at constant pressure, or we add it at constant volume. We want to know what happens in each case. So let's look first at the constant pressure case. So we could look at this from the idea of Le Chatelier's principle, that adding inert is going to, at constant pressure, it's going to lower partial pressures, the pressure of A and the pressure of B. Because the total pressure is constant, inert has some pressure. We've lowered those pressures. The system's going to want to respond to make more moles. And this is Le Chatelier's principle. More moles is going to try and increase the pressure. So we've lowered the pressure, the system's going to go to the right to increase the pressure. So that's looking at it from Le Chatelier's principle. Let's look at the actual calculation to convince ourselves that's what's happening. So the equilibrium constant is the activity of B, I'll use the hat to indicate it's in a mixture, squared because of the stoichiometric coefficient here. The activity of A, first power, and I can write the activity in terms of fugacity of B, fugacity of B at standard conditions, that quantity squared, fugacity of A in the mixture, fugacity of pure A, standard conditions. If we assume ideal gases, the ideas aren't going to change if they're real, but it's certainly easier to visualize. And the fugacity of B is just a partial pressure B divided by the standard state pure component, which is 1 bar, that quantity squared, and this is the pressure of A over 1 bar also, which means this would be the pressure of B squared over the pressure of A. As long as we keep in mind, we have to write the pressures in units of bar. And so let's continue in order to make it easy to visualize this. Let's write this in terms of mole fractions. So the mole fraction of B times the total pressure, that's the partial pressure B, mole fraction of A times the total pressure. So we have mole fraction of B squared, pressure, the mole fraction of A. Well, this is number of moles of B over the total number of moles, and then likewise number of moles of A over the total number of moles. And so what we end up with is number of moles of B squared over the total number of moles and number of moles of A and pressure. So now we can look at this and say what happens at constant pressure if I change the number of moles. So if I change the number of moles, I haven't changed the equilibrium constant. That's a constant because temperature is constant. I've kept the pressure constant. If I increase the total number of moles by adding an inert, then I must increase B. So B must increase when in total increases. And so again, this tells us the reaction must go to the right when I add an inert at constant pressure. The same result that we predict from Le Chatelier's principle. Okay, now let's look at the case for constant volume. So our equilibrium expression is the same if we do this at constant volume, but let's look at what's going to happen. So I'm going to write it this way to make it easier to visualize. Pressure over the total number of moles. If I add an inert, I'm going to increase the total number of moles, but I'm also going to increase the pressure such that the pressure over total number of moles is just RT over V from the ideal gas law. R is constant, of course, temperature is constant, it's constant volume. So this term is constant. In other words, we've increased the total number of moles and we proportionally increased the pressure. So all these terms stay constant. So there's no effect on equilibrium when we add an inert at constant volume. We've kept the partial pressures of A and B the same, right? Now our equilibrium expression, remember the other way of writing our equilibrium expression is the pressure of B squared over the pressure of A. Add an inert constant volume, we increase the total pressure. We don't change those partial pressures, therefore there's no change, the equilibrium is still satisfied. So the situation is very different, constant volume and constant pressure.